Up till yesterday, I was on day six. I don't remember if I hit nighttime day six or if I'm still during the day, but we'll see here. I really don't remember. So, alright, Oktoberfest, start game. The idea of this playthrough was to make it to day seven, do the first horde, show everybody what kind of basics you need and stuff. It wasn't a real... I'm not real super serious about this playthrough. Now, when I'm doing co-op with someone, oh, yeah, I get super serious. Because then it's... Everybody has their own specific task to do. Everybody does it. The team either succeeds or fails depending on the ability of others. And that makes it more exciting for me. Alright. Here we go. Yeah, it's almost day seven. So yeah, it was nighttime day six plus. I feel like I'm gonna get totally screwed. The zombies are gonna eat my face. We'll see. I mean, I've got good positional defenses. You know, I don't have... You know, it's not like I'm babying the zombies when they come up to the house. They're gonna die, but... They're gonna inflict some serious damage on stuff around them. Because really, ideally, I'd like, to have a wall around. I guess a wall is day 14. Defense is outside the wall, that's more day 14. But it's definitely not going to be possible for me. This one on day 7, definitely not possible to get enough wood to do a wall. And even if I had enough wood, I don't have a claw hammer. If I had a claw hammer and a lot of wood, we could make this happen. But, as I said, no claw hammer, not a lot of wood. Equals not a lot of success. And I'm still going to gather wood. I'm not going to just roll over and be done, but also at the same time, I know what I can get done before the horde and how long it'll take. I do love how these are brighter piles here. Undetected. Then you can see where you need to harvest them. Whoa, untouched stuff here. Did not see that before. Awesome. Thank you. second. Yeah. Stone axe. The 84, and that's with no stand crafting, so doing pretty good. I'm gonna get some stone. I'm gonna get stone while I'm out here. Why not? Still undetected. Go for another stone. I'd like to have 500 and make one right over here, so I'm just gonna go for it, I think. Hey. There we go. This axe is almost toast. Didn't fall. Alright. Made a few there, so I'll have a little bit of inventory. Oh, what was that? Gotta check my phone real quick. Oh, nothing important. Okay, just... daughter will be getting home here in about a half hour or so, so... she's been having a good year at school so far, I think, so... things have been going good. Weather's been nice. All right. Okay, so the corn, potatoes, coffee beans, everything looks good. I need to do back here too is dig away another layer of dirt. I still can't get over it. Even though they changed the volume of it, that lightning is still loud. Or, well, thunder, but, you know. The stupid saying, lightning's loud. It's the thunder. Well, I guess actually technically what thunder is when lightning comes down and the stream of light is so bright that as the light disappears, the air around it comes crashing back in, and that's what causes the thunder. So, I guess I'm kind of half right. not want to have to dig more. Especially when my level for my mining is so low. Or die, oh, that always takes care of it too. Died enough times. It's a shame, first day playing this on this playthrough, I found an army camp, but I got blown up like 4 times trying to clean out all the mines. Really sucked. See, I want them to come down the hill into the spikes. I don't want them to be able to, you know, jump over the spikes. And if the hill was coming down, they could, you know, kind of get over those first couple rows of spikes. But if the hill's eroded away, so they come down, they're walking in a straight line into the spikes. Opposed to a weird hooked shape. Oh, which reminds me, got to see. This is that army camp. We can get rid of it. No. Okay, that one I got. And I'm assuming this. Yep. That one I got. I went up there and got those two. Haven't gotten any of these other ones. The one here at the bridge. That one. Or that one right there. But I want to mark off the ones that I did get. Because I don't want to forget. I got them last episode. I just didn't take the X's off the map. So now I did. Should be good to go. Because there'll be another airdrop in about, well, 1 hour game time, so that's roughly 3 to 5 minutes maximum. Well, I guess it's almost 11, so it's more like 2 to 3 minutes. But whatever. Hopefully everything in the stream is working good, because I did have that little problem earlier, so we'll see. It's either going to come out nice or come out terrible. You know, matter of fact, I can look at the, look at Twitch right now and see. It doesn't show any lag, so that's good. Okay. Because, yeah, using the Xbox interface, if it's lagging, it'll say lagging right on it. It'll say you need to lower your speed or whatever. That's because I was doing updates on the computer. Oh, I'm out of stamina. It's 12. The plane should. Yep, there it is. It's off. That sucks, because that's where I already was. Save waypoint. Nice. My shovels and my skill are getting up high enough where plowing through this dirt now. All I need is one more hide and I'll be able to make a forge. You know, I gotta make the bellows. I need 20 animal hide. I've got 19. So next time I go out to kill an animal, I'll have the forge ready and then I can build, you know, iron tools. And then after a little while longer, I can upgrade steel, you know, get the steel from the skills menu and start making steel instead of just iron. Once you make steel shovels, that lasts for a very long time. It seems to get calm right before the horde comes. You don't see as many zombies. There's not as many animals. Everything kind of settles down. I think they lower the spawn rate, so once the horde does come, it doesn't really lag your connection. Oh, it's clay. Oh, all right. I'll take that. I wonder why it looks so weird. Should have known. Everything I'll need once the forge gets going is clay, so good to get it. Simple. And now I've kind of cleared off this hill. Ideally, I'd like to do one more, reduce the hill back one more layer. And then what I want to do is build a wall all the way around. And I want to put one row of spikes, you know, wood log spikes at least on the outside. That way when zombies come, they gotta stand there at the wall and take the overtime damage from the wood log spikes. Oh, that's that dirt I placed. So what we'll do is we'll fix this up. Do I have any wood frames? No, I don't. Okay. Four. There we go. That's a quick tip for leveling ground. You place those frames down on stuff that looks hilly, and it levels out the ground for you. And if you've got an embankment like this, if I were to put these frames here, it'd turn it into a straight line across. So I know what the actual height is. It's a good time saver when you're trying to figure out how many layers of dirt you gotta dig out before you reach your desired level. See, now with this gone, you know, nice and flat here, I can see this gonna be at least two. And if that's two, that means this is gonna be three up here. And then back down over here, down to two. Goes all the way along till you get to the end and there's one. So. Anyway, Zombie Horde will be coming soon. And I will deal with them. Dispatch them as quickly as possible. The spikes will. I'll be inside. Looking out, seeing how things are going. Oh, there we go, over 100 now. Get almost tied here from the horde. Cowering in a corner, scared shitless. Got much time left now. It's gonna be horde time. Did get a little clay from this dig out here too. So this is good. Oh. This is 3 blocks now. The shovel's almost toast. Okay, there, while my stamina's replenishing, make another one. Oh, my crops must be fully grown. I see the yellow over there, the goldenrod. That's good. One last thing I have to worry about. Alright, I think that's gonna be it. Till the horde, cause, well, no. Not even 1800, I got time. I can do this. A little more. I'll go to 1900 and then I'll stop moving. See, while this is, while I'm letting my stamina regen, let me check my, yep, still says everything's good. So we'll just, supposedly the stream's still good, no lag or anything, but true test is once it's done and I can see it, I'll know if it was lagging or not. Almost to the end here, digging. Let my stretch out, let my stamina regen. There we go. Stomach's growling because my food meter almost down to nothing. I couldn't have a better time. Look at that, 1900. Broke the shovel right as it was quitting time. Corn's still not grown yet. Coffee beans are, but blueberries still aren't. They're not going to be done at the same time, though. They're a step behind. So when the corn gets finished, then the blueberries will be almost done. So I'm waiting until the corn finishes before I grab anything. Grabbing. Frames. There we go. Now, seeable damage. Doing is I'm repairing around these windows, or upgrading around these windows, I mean, because when I do, this is the area that's going to get attacked, and if they would happen to break through, it'd take them a lot longer. Break through if they have to break through multiple layers. And I'll start to overheat if I don't take those off. Oh, that's what I need to do too. Spend points. I see I need to be level 20. What level am I? 12. Yeah, I'm not even close. Okay, so I'll need 20 points, which is 4 levels. So that'd be, I can get to level 16. Then I have to worry, so can spend 4 levels with a point. Alright. What is it? Health number I can't do yet. Should do that. It's very important. Not right away, you know, but it's very important later. Maybe get something on minor 69er as well, but next level I'll do that. I'll do minor 69er. So minor 69er next level. And I do, once I get that last piece of animal hide, I'll make my forge. And once I make the forge, I'll throw in the clay, and some stone, and some iron, and get things going. Hopefully he's gonna be a new one. Getting them to look at me so they'll come this way. Because now they'll walk through the spikes at an angle. I always love how they just do their boots and stuff. There's that room over there. Around this way. Oh, come on. Clearly that didn't hit him. Alright, everybody over here. I love that move. If I can get them all to come over through here, they'll break me these spikes and I can drop down and pick up all their loot. Probably not gonna be able to get any of that stuff. Okay, I'm gonna be dying here real soon, so we're over here in this open area. There we go. Alright, now here we go. Back out the door. You're wet. Well, duh. Hope that they give me the obvious answers. I am wet. Did not know that, I swear. This. I did direct them all over here, so I got a concentrated damage. So that bee comes down and tries to kill me. Nope, he turned and went away. Figures. There's a little bit of damage around the door area. Not much. And almost nothing on the back here. It looks like really all of them did. They came here when I lured them over. Finish that one. There we go. And see, some of these are easier just to break down. Just this grouping. I don't want to sit and tear this whole grouping here, so. Alright. Plus, I need a way to get out here. So. Okay, so. Make, let's say. 20. Five wood log spikes. And that seems about right. You know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna break these out. I'm not gonna waste my time repairing them. If I had the claw hammer, it'd be different. Since I don't. I wonder how that one managed to escape damage. I mean, I hit it once and then I repaired it after I hit it, but. It was totally undamaged. Alright, let's see here. These don't all have to be 100%. But if there's ones that look real bad, they'll get replaced. The surrounding ones will be repaired. Do I have? Oh, I got tons. How about? I One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, five should do. Build another 10 wood logs first. Accidentally balked myself out. Stupid, but problem will be solved. There we go. Okay. Just make 15. Still might not even be enough, but let's see. Yeah, it won't be enough. Calculate for those there, so I'll for sure be. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. I would have. I'm gonna need one more. No, actually, I calculated for those two. I'd the exact right amount. Oh. Okay. And I will. Even if I have the forge, I can't make a claw hammer because I don't have the blueprint. So, which, I think that's weird. You can build a pick, you can build a shovel, you can build a hoe, but you can't build a hammer. Yeah, seems kinda off-putting. You find that a little strange. Considering a hammer is easier to make. All you have to do is have a block of iron. Now, if there was a crude hammer, and then a good, you know, a better hammer, if there's two qualities, you'd make a better hammer, probably. If you're you know how tempering methods and things work, you'd make a better hammer. But anybody can melt metal down and make a block. That's really what was it. I thought I heard something. Really, that's what the hammer is. It's just a block of iron. Okay, so let's just make another 10 spikes. Placing a few spikes. Almost stepped out and died there. Almost have my base defense fixed back up. Wanted to get that bee though, because honey's good stuff. Saw another one up there, like way up. But I don't see him anywhere. He must have took off. Nice to get more, but game lagged just a little there. Almost died, not gonna lie. About boot my pants. Speaking of poop my pants, my daughter's home, so probably gonna be getting off here real soon. Hey, don't hit me. That wasn't very nice. No. But really, gonna get off here real soon. I'm just gonna repair these defenses. That'll be it. Alright, let's start backing out of the dead zone. Alright. Ta-da! Next time I play, I'm gonna wanna start building that wall. So, to everybody that's listening, have a good rest of the day. This is me signing off.